Hi, my name is Atiye Tahiri. I am a PhD student working in the Perceptual Engineering Lab in the CS department at UCSB, and I'm excited to present our work on designing a first-person shooter game for quadriplegics like me. In this talk, I will walk you through the problem identification, our proposed solution, and the strategies for making it work. Despite the technological advances, video gaming still requires motor skills to use traditional game inputs, making them inaccessible to people with mobility issues. So we thought, why not use the muscles that they can control voluntarily? And from there, we came up with the idea of facial expressions to control the game, based on which we built our system. We co-created our system with one case study. I was the subject of this study because I've been affected by SMA ever since I was a child. The picture is of me playtesting our game. Here is an overview of our pipeline. Our primary input method that is detected by a camera is the user's face. We process the video in real time using OpenFace 2.0. Our secondary input method is a speech, which we convert to text using Google's Cloud Speech API. The outputs from OpenFace and Speech Recognition that are facial action units or AUs and text are mapped to the keyboard, and each key is then mapped to an action in the video game. To test our input system, we built a desktop FPS game in Unreal Engine. For the facial input, OpenFace detects AUs from the input video. AUs refer to facial muscle movements. We define six facial expressions derived from AUs in our system, each of which is mapped to a certain action in the game. Under each face, you can see the corresponding mappings. As a secondary input, we added a speech recognition using Google's Cloud Speech API. The user's voice command is instantly converted to text, then checked for specific keywords such as pause or jump. But we noticed a delay with the speech in an FPS game, so we use it only to reload the character's weapon, to pause the game, and to navigate menus. We created a customization interface by which we let the user adjust the sensitivity of the system. Once the user selects the type of AU detection, depending on their choice, the next step can be adjusting the detection threshold. All changes take effect immediately. To best adapt the system to the player's strengths, the system was designed in an iterative way. We considered the frequency of actions. For example, for the repetitive actions, we used facial expressions I was most comfortable with. Multimodal input and feedback was considered since response time can vary from one video game to the next, so relying on a single input can limit the types of interactions. Ultimately, we designed the games to provide a fun and flexible gaming experience for everyone. Series of playtesting iterations revealed some challenges that needed to be addressed. Cutting zombie movement speed and number in half, or auto-aiming for shooting are some of the many configurations we made. Additionally, for turning the character left and right, we employed facial expressions to operate as a toggle. To make the game more exciting, we scattered health and ammo pickups around the map and created timed pickups so that zombies get killed after one shot instead of seven. We also used some action background music to create tension. I invite you to watch a short demo of playing our FPS game.
Option one.
In this work, we designed a facial expression recognition based game controller for credit batteries. It has a customization interface so people of different abilities can use it. It was a co-creation approach with one test study. We designed a desktop FPS game for playtesting, emphasizing user agency, user comfort, memorability, and ease of use. Thank you.